Thank you. I would like to invite our panelists for this very interesting panel about cybersecurity and the link between state and private enterprises. Please help me welcome Michal Blumenstick-Braverman to the panel, Gadi Tirosh from JVP, and the Honorable Member of Knesset, Robert Ilatov. Please join me. Thank you. I would like to introduce the panelists and then go directly. First, I would like to thank our sponsor, Fairfax County, Virginia, the home of the Homeland Security Companies. Michal is the CEO of RSA Israel and General Manager of Global Solutions for RSA. RSA Israel designs, develops, and operates a unique suite of products and services that combat cybercrime. More than 300 million users worldwide are protected by the IPV suite, and in 2011 alone, the suite stopped cyber fraud in more than $3 billion. Michal grew revenues of Ciota, which was acquired by RSA, from $10 million to over $200 million, becoming the second line of business for RSA. Thank you, Michal, for joining us. I would also like to introduce a member of Knesset, the Honorable Robert Ilatov, Chairman of Israel Beitenu section and party, Chairman of the high-tech effort of the Israeli parliament, and Chairman of the subcommittee for advancement of the high-tech industries, member of the economic committee of the Knesset, and member of the foreign and security committee of the Knesset. Thank you for joining us, Robert. And finally, I'd like to introduce Gadi Tirosh, partner in Jerusalem Venture Partners, with a strong background in media-related software and internet-based R&D organization. Gadi is a key member of the Jerusalem Venture Partners media team and a board member of a number of key investments of Jerusalem Venture Partners. Gadi held, prior to joining Jerusalem Venture Partners, senior positions in the Israeli high-tech industry, lately with NDS, the encryption company. Without further ado, I'd like to ask the panelists each a question which I think will bring to mind. This is a very interesting week for cybersecurity, being taking place in a time where the Israeli government has just finished a week of deliberations about the effort of cybersecurity, with Prime Minister Netanyahu mentioning that as the biggest threat to Israel and to global security, more than physical threats. With that said, I would like to ask Member of Parliament Ilatov to come and answer and describe to us the government initiative named Cyber Valley in the South that he's leading, as well as what are the other government initiatives in Israel and how they are linked to the private industry. I understand you want to answer from here, which is fine.
Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The initiative for the Cyber Valley in the Eastern Negev came from the three simultaneous factors. One, there is a growing need for cyber-related member power in Israel. The member power is needed in order to develop new capabilities and maintain Israel's technological edge in this area. The manpower is also needed in order to fill the ranks of cyber and IT security personnel in the various government agencies, defense forces, critical infrastructure, and enterprises. People with capabilities in the area of cybersecurity are in a high demand and enjoy their salaries. Two, the most of the Israel high-tech industry is concentrated in the central area near Tel Aviv. The manpower in the Eastern Negev is underutilized in the term of the high-tech industry. Building up high-tech industry in this area can significantly aid in its economical development. Three, the army units which have the largest need for cyber-related personnel are migrating from central Israel to Negev. The three factors combined led to formulation of a plan which consists of establishing an ecosystem related to cyber capabilities in the Eastern Negev. The ecosystem will include the following. One, a middle and high boarding school focused on technological and cyber related areas. The school will be guided also by the needs of the relevant army units. 2, the academic faculty focusing on cyber security in cooperation with the leading academic institute in Israel. 3, in order to provide industry with incentive to migrate their cyber-related business lines to the Eastern Negev area, they will receive a significant economical benefits coupled with an advantage with the graduates from the local cyber faculty. 4, students will receive a full stipend covering their tuition and board during their entire studies. The bottom line of the ecosystem focused on enhancing the capabilities of local manpower in line with the needs of the military, creating an incentive of students to attend university local and an incentive of industry of migrate their cyber LOBS to the areas. Thank you very much.